हेलो, गुड इवनिंग। आज हम इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स के बारे में बात करेंगे। सो सबसे पहले आइए जानते हैं कि न्यूक्लिक एसिड को डिस्कवर कैसे किया गया। 1869 में फ्रेडरिक मिस्टर एक ऐसा फर्स्ट पर्सन हुआ है जिसने पस सेल के साइटोप्लाज्म में से न्यूक्लियाई को निकाला और उसमें से एसिडिक मटेरियल को एक्सट्रैक्ट किया, जिसको उसने न्यूक्लेन का नाम दिया। He found that न्यूक्लेन consists of unusual amount of phosphorus, but not sulfur. तो उसने देखा कि उसमें बहुत ज्यादा अमाउंट में फॉस्फोरस प्रेजेंट है। After 20 years, in 1889, Richard Altman used the term nucleic acid instead of nuclein. He found that nucleic acids are associated with various kinds of proteins known as nucleoproteins. Then there was classification made about nucleic acids. There are two kinds of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA. DNA stands for deoxyribose nucleic acid and RNA stands for ribose nucleic acid. DNA is found in the chromosomes of the nucleus, whereas RNA is found in the ribosomes that are known as the protein factories of the cell. DNA is found in plant cells, animal cells, whereas RNA is found in some of the viruses like riboviruses that are RNA containing viruses. Now let's talk about the difference between nucleosides and nucleotides. Levine showed that nucleic acids can be broken down into the smaller units known as nucleotides. So what are nucleosides? Nucleosides jo hote hain, they act as intermediate units for the synthesis as well as degradation of the nucleic acids, nucleotides. Nucleotides ko banane ke liye bhi aur nucleotides ko jab toda jata hai tab bhi nucleosides ki synthesis hoti hai. So next point is, न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स जो होते हैं दे आर बेसिक इन रिएक्शन और न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स जो होते हैं दे आर एसिडिक इन रिएक्शन. न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स जो है दे आर ग्लाइकोसाइड्स, जो न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स हैं दे आर ग्लाइकोसिडिक एस्टर्स. देन वी टॉक अबाउट न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स जो है वो दो चीजों के बने होते हैं, नाइट्रोजिनस बेसिस एज वेल एज पेंटोस शुगर. जो न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स हैं वो तीन चीजों को मिला के बनते हैं, नाइट्रोजिनस बेसिस, पेंटोस शुगर एंड फॉस्फोरिक एसिड. सो फाइव कार्बन राइबोस शुगर इज प्रेजेंट इन डीएनए एंड आरएनए. In DNA, the 5-carbon ribose sugar is deoxyribose and in RNA, it is the ribose sugar only. So now let's talk about purines and pyrimidines. With each ribose sugar, one or two carbon nitrogen rings are attached. In purines, there is the presence of 2 carbon nitrogen rings. Whereas in case of pyrimidines, there is the presence of only and only 1 carbon nitrogen ring, that is 6-membered compound. In case of pyrimidines, I have written the examples of pyrimidines, that is thiamine and cytosine. Purines are adenine and guanine. These are the nitrogenous bases present in the DNA. Purines occupy more space in the DNA, whereas pyrimidines occupy less space in the DNA. Then deoxyribose is linked at third carbon in case of pyrimidines, because it contains only and only one carbon nitrogen ring. Whereas deoxyribose sugar is attached to the ninth position of the purines, as it contains nine membered ring structure. Later on, Chargaff also showed that the ratio of adenine and thymine and cytosine and guanine is constant in case of DNA, and it was also shown that number of purines is equal to number of pyrimidine bases in the DNA. This is all about the introduction of the nucleic acids. Keep on watching my videos. I'll continue posting videos on different topics. Thanks a lot.